and OBG experts. Here I am for discussion about the MTP Act, MTP Amendment Act 2021. This act was actually, the MTP Act was passed in August 1971 and it came into the force in the April 1972. So in all the states of India and all the union territories of India except in J&K, in 1972 it was came into the force. Now first of all I will discuss about the some basic point of the MTP. After that we will discuss about the amendment which took place in the 2021. The first of all I am discussing about the some grounds or some indications of the abortions. The first indication of abortion or MTP is the any medical conditions or any diseases which is present in mother and which causes any physical or mental harm to the, which causes any physical, mental or serious injury to the mother, in that case MTP can be done. The second indication is the humanitarian indication, which includes if pregnancy occurred as a result of rape, in that case the MTP can be sought. And the third indication is the when there is substantial risk of the child being born with the any fetal anomalies, like the any chromosomal defect, like any structural defect, like any genetical defect, such as Down syndrome, such as hemophilia and syphilis, in such cases MTP can be done. Okay, these are the some indications which were mentioned in the 1972 MTP Act, and in 2021 the MTP Amendment Act was passed in our Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay, so first now I am coming to the amendment which took place in the 2021. Overall I am discussing the 6th amendment. How many amendments, guys? 6 amendment which took place in the MTP Act. Okay, the first amendment is regarding the duration. The first amendment is regarding the duration. Okay, so before 20 weeks of gestation, before 20 weeks of gestation, the opinion of only one doctor is enough. The opinion of only one RMP is enough. Okay, and after 20 weeks to 24 weeks. After 20 weeks to 24 weeks, if MTP is done, in that case, the opinion of two doctors, the opinion of two doctors or two RMP, registered medical practitioners, are needed for conduction of MTP. Okay, in earlier MTP Act, after 12 weeks, the opinion of two doctors were needed. But now it is changed. But now it is amended that up to 20 weeks, for MTP up to 20 weeks, only opinion of one doctor is enough. After 20 to 24 weeks, the opinion of two doctors are needed. And after 24 weeks to up to term, in case MTP is done after 24 weeks to up to term, in that case a medical board, the MTP can be done on the recommendation or on the opinion of the medical board which is constituted or which is established by the state government or union territories. The medical board consists of 4 members, which includes gynecologist, pediatrician and radiologist or sonologist, and any member which is appointed by the state government or by the union territories. Okay guys, so this is the first amendment regarding the duration of MTP. Okay, clear? Now now we come to the second amendment. Second amendment is related to the contraception failure. Okay, if pregnancy occurred as a result of contraception failure in married woman, in unmarried women, and from partner side also. In earlier act, it was only for the married woman. If contraception failure occurred in the married woman, in that case MTP can be done. But in amendment the scope of MTP is enhanced. if contraception failure occurred in married woman, in unmarried woman, or from partner side is also included here. So this is the second amendment which took place in the MTP Amendment Act 2021. Okay guys, now we come to the third amendment. The third amendment is related to the special category people. In such cases, the upper gestational age limit for MTP is enhanced from 20 weeks to 24 weeks. Okay, from 20 weeks to 24 weeks in special category peoples, like if pregnancy occurred as a result of rape, incest, or if pregnancy occurred in a minor, or in a special category people, or differently able women. Okay, in that case, the upper gestational age limit for the MTP is enhanced from 20 weeks to 24 weeks. This is the third amendment which took place in the MTP Act 2021. So remember this, guys. This is also very important for your examination point of view. Okay, now we come to the fourth amendment. The fourth amendment is related to the any fetal anomalies. Listen it carefully. If there is any substantial risk of fetus being born with any fetal anomalies, in such cases there is no age limit for MTP. There is no gestational age limit for MTP, means MTP can be done up to the term, because all we know that the fetal anomalies occur at a different level of the gestation. So in such cases, if fetal is being born with any fetal anomalies, that risk is there. In such cases, there is no gestational age limit for conduction of MTP. This is also very important, so you should keep remember this amendment also. Now we come to the fifth amendment is in case of any emergency or life threatening condition. If woman is facing any emergency or life threatening condition, in such cases the opinion of only one doctor is enough, because that is a matter of the life of the woman. Okay, so in such cases, the opinion of one doctor is quite enough, and it is very general. So now we come to the sixth amendment, and the sixth amendment related to the MTP Act 2021, that is the confidentiality. The confidentiality of the woman's her name and her other details should be kept in privacy, except law enforcing agency. Okay, any unlawful disclosure of the woman's detail and woman's record is a punishable act under this amendment act. In such cases, if any details of the woman are disclosed by any person which is involved in the MTP, in such cases the imprisonment of 1 year with or without fine is recommended. Okay guys, and these are the sixth amendment which took place in the MTP Amendment Act 2021. And remember guys, this MTP Amendment Act was introduced in our Lok Sabha on 2nd March 2020. Okay, introduced on 2nd March 2020, and it was passed by the Lok Sabha that is the 17th March 2020. And again, this MTP Amendment Act was passed by the Rajya Sabha on 16th of March 2021, and it was published in the Gazette of India. It was published in the Gazette of India on 25th March 2021. Okay, so on 25th March 2021, this MTP Amendment Act came into force in all the state of India, including J&K, including Jammu and Kashmir. Okay guys, so today I discussed about overall sixth amendment which took place in this MTP Amendment Act, and you all remember all these six amendments. These are very important for your upcoming examination, like NORSET, like NIMHANS, and like ESIC examination and all CHO examination. है ना, बिकॉज दीज आर मेंशन ओनली इन द न्यूअर बुक्स और इन न्यू एडिशंस बुक्स, इन ओल्डर एडिशंस दीज अमेंडमेंट्स वर नॉट मेंशंस. सो दीज अमेंडमेंट्स वर रिलेटेड टू द फर्स्ट वन इज रिगार्डिंग द ड्यूरेशन, द सेकेंड वन इज रिगार्डिंग द contraception failure, and third one is related to the special category people, and fourth one is related to fetal anomalies, and fifth one is related to the any emergency or life threatening conditions, and sixth one is related to the confidentiality of the woman's record or privacy of the woman that must be maintained by all the personnel which are involved in the MTB. So thank you so much guys for watching this video, and keep like and keep sharing Udaan Nursing Academy for any amendment or for any updates for your all the topics. Thank you so much guys. Thank you so much.